former freshman congressman George Santos, before he got expelled by members of his own party, is reportedly in negotiations to basically resolve his federal criminal fraud charges. And that's according to new court filings. Now, here's a reminder of what he's been charged with. Santos pleaded not guilty in May to a 13-count indictment charging him with defrauding prospective political supporters by laundering funds to pay for his personal expenses, illegally receiving unemployment benefits while he was employed, and lying to the House about his assets. Then in October, he pleaded not guilty to further accusations of charging donors' credit cards without their consent and reporting a bogus $500,000 campaign loan. And while he pleaded not guilty, those who worked on his campaign have admitted to guilt when it comes to some of this stuff. So Samuel Mille, a former campaign fundraiser for Santos, last month pleaded guilty in Long Island federal court to wire fraud related to impersonating a top aide to ex-House Speaker Kevin McCarthy while soliciting donations for Santos. In October, Santos's former campaign treasurer, Nancy Marks, pleaded guilty in the same court to multiple campaign finance felonies related to her work for him. So like all these people surrounding him are like, yeah, we did it. We plead guilty. George Santos pleads not guilty. But now he's like, maybe I should take a plea deal. Maybe that'll work in my interest. So US attorney Breon Pace's office said in a new filing that the prosecutors and George Santos are engaging in negotiations for a potential plea deal. The disclosure came in a letter from the US Attorney's Office in Brooklyn to Judge Joanna Seibert or Seibert. It proposes a joint agenda with Santos's lawyer for a previously scheduled statute conference that happened yesterday in the morning. The parties are presently engaged in plea negotiations with the goal of resolving this matter without the need for a trial. The parties wish to continue those negotiations over the next 30 days. Now, what I love about this is that in talking to the press about a potential plea deal, it does appear that Santos has admitted some guilt. So Santos will appear back in court on January 23rd for an additional status conference. Prosecutors also renewed their request to begin a trial in May or June instead of September if a plea deal is not reached. And Santos isn't opposed to a plea deal. In fact, he says the following, okay? The trial is not until September and a plea deal is not off the table. So there's obviously conversations taking place, especially after what happened in Congress, and we'll see. Now, CBS New York's Marsha Kramer also asked Santos if he was afraid of going to jail. And why would you be afraid to go to jail if you're innocent, right? And here's what he said. I think everybody should be afraid of going to jail. It's not a pretty place. I definitely want to work very hard to avoid that as much as possible. Okay. All right. Well, take the plea deal because you're definitely guilty, in my opinion. John, thoughts?
Yeah, I get it. I would be afraid too. I would say, let this be a reminder to every congressperson that is still in Congress that because most of you are breaking the law on a regular basis, maybe you should clean up prison now so that if you end up going there, it won't be as bad. Not the worst idea necessarily. I do have a legal question for you. Can you film and sell cameos from inside of prison?
I'm really happy that you're asking me, a real legal expert, this question. And my answer to that is, I have no idea.
But okay, because that would make it not as bad for him if he could continue his side hustle from in there. Look, plea deals are a thing. He should have as much access to one as any non-former representative and no more. The idea that he would get any special treatment because of his time in the public eye, I think is ridiculous, especially considering what he did with that time. So look, if most people in these sort of situations can get access to a plea deal that keeps them out of prison, then he should be treated no more harshly than them. But otherwise, he appears to have broken the law in multiple instances. He conned basically everyone who trusted him. It would seem weird if he didn't end up in prison, at least for a little while.
Yeah, look, I think that if he takes a plea deal, it's probably unlikely he's going to serve any time behind bars. I'm fine with that. I want justice to be served. I want him to pay some penalty for what he's engaged in. I mean, he stole from his own donors. He was charging their credit cards without their consent for OnlyFans and for Botox. It's so wrong. And yeah, I totally agree with you. He shouldn't be treated differently from anyone else. And so we'll see how this plays out. But I do think that he should take the plea deal. Seems like there's mounting evidence that incriminates him here. And if you don't take the plea deal, that's when you're more likely to serve time behind bars.
Hey, thanks for watching the video. We really appreciate it, guys. And we appreciate it if you become members, because that allows us to be independent, honest, progressive, all the things that you don't get from corporate media. And all of that is because of you guys. Hit the join button below and become one of us. Become a Young Turk.